And welcome to Encounters in Ecto tonight with Michelle and myself. We're going to be talking a variety of topics tonight, so don't go away. We'll be right back.
I've been alive for 4.5 centuries. I am immortal.
Okay.
And welcome to Encounters in Ecto. Hey, Michelle.
Hey, how you doing?
How's everybody doing out there? Hope you're ready for this.
Oh my gosh, we have got some crazy stuff today.
Oh yeah, never a shortage of that, right?
Never. Ghost stories, alien stuff, just your normal average every other Saturday hoopla of crazy.
Yep, absolutely. So what are we going to start out with tonight?
I got a story here. It was kind of last minute. I'm still trying to sort through it here. Okay. I'll just read what you have.
Okay.
This is a nurse that I used to work with years ago, and she's telling me a story of what helped her go to an early retirement. She said after this happened, she said she was weighing the options back and forth. And she says, I wasn't sure if I wanted to retire early or not, but this pushed me to the edge of definitely I need to get out of this business. She worked in a hospital, you know, where people basically, you know, just get comfort care for dying. And she said it was around 9 o'clock at night, and she saw one of her patients was starting to get worse. So she called the family and said, you know, you might want to come in, and it's not going to be long. So she said about 10 minutes after she made the calls, a man came in and said that he was the man's youngest son. She said, I'd never seen him before, but I had no reason to believe that he wasn't related to him. His name was Tim, and I sent him back and asked him if he needed anything. He told me no. Said I sat there for a while, and for some reason, it kept bothering me about this man. I don't know why. I should have never let him in because he wasn't on the list, but we don't have... Oh, she says, we don't have, like, a protocol list unless it specifically says, you know, only certain people can come. She said, about 15 minutes later, family members came in, and I told them, well, your brother's already in there. And they all kind of looked at me strange and said, what do you mean, our brother? So your brother, Tim, he came in. He wanted to visit your dad. I just sat there confused and stuttering my words because I knew something wasn't right. So I ran back there with them, and when we got there, my patient was already deceased. Oh, my God. The patient was already deceased by just a few minutes, and the family looked at me and asked me to describe the person that was in there, and I said, I told them he didn't do anything. He was there. They're like, that's not what we're... She said they were very upset, saying, that's not what we're asking you. And she's got all these exclamation points. So apparently they were very anxious. So she described the person to him, you know, that he was around 5'10", very slender build, had a ball cap on, and had extremely piercing blue eyes. Mm-hmm. So they all sat there. They started crying and holding each other, and she couldn't figure out what was going on. So I sat there confused, and I didn't understand. And the CNA that was in the room with the patient said that no man ever showed up.
Okay.
That even though she had sent him back, the CNA that was sitting with the patient never seen this man. Then the family was all upset and crying, and I finally got it out of them. Said their brother Tim had died 22 years before he was hit by a train.
Oh, my Lord.
Oh, God, that's chills.
Yeah. Holy crap.
But their brother Tim was hit by a train, and their father had never really gotten over his death. Because he's the one that sent him to the store.
Oh.
And the person she described is exactly what he was wearing the night he died.
Oh, my God.
And, yeah. Oh, wow.
Shoo.
Okay. Yeah, so this is... sorry, I was kind of reading as I went along. So basically what happened was there was a CNA sitting with the dying man, because that's usually the process. The nurse stays at the desk and somebody will stay with the person until the family gets there. So this other person showed up. She sent him back. The CNA never saw him.
Ooh.
In the meantime, the other family showed up and she was alerted that the man had passed away. They all went back there and the family you know, asked her who this person was, and she thought they were accusing her of something, right, which right. they weren't. They were just very curious. And the person she described, his name and what he was wearing, was their brother Tim, who had died 22 years before.
Wow.
Said he was there to see his dad.
He probably helped him cross. That's what yeah. they say, that you'll see family or, you know, a close relative that will be waiting for you to help you.
She said after this, that was cemented my decision that I wanted to retire. I was tired of seeing things like this. As you know well, as she says, you well know, Michelle, you see these things every day and constantly throughout yep. your career. That's true.
Yep. Wow.
True.
Wow, that's just, ooh.
Yeah. Ugh. Gave me chills when she said it.
Oh. Yeah, oh my God.
Oh my God.
Wow. Crazy, crazy stuff. Yeah.
Isn't it? Oh my gosh.
Yeah, but I believe it. Because they do say that.
Well, this person, I believe it. She's yeah. an older nurse that I used to work with. And yeah, so I totally believe it. And I've seen some.
Yeah.
You know, I've worked in the nursing field, and it's like that. There's so many things. There's so many things that we have seen, even with my own father, when my own father passed. You know, when yeah. my father was in the process of dying, he was totally out of it all day, and all of a sudden, his room, I asked my sister, I said, did you open the window? She's like, no. And his room was, I mean, ice cold, freezing. All of a sudden, he opened his eyes, and he was looking up at the ceiling, smiling.
Yeah, that happened with my mom, too, when she passed.
Yeah, and we like went in front of him. We didn't know if he was smiling. My sister thought he was smiling. I was like, dude, move. And she put her head up, and he was just staring at the ceiling, smiling.
Yeah. My mom was kind of looking.
He passed within a half an hour after that.
Passed me, like, sideways over to the, in the corner of the room. And you could see where she was looking, and she was smiling. And I believe it was my brother. So.
Oh, probably, yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Because he passed before her. So I think she saw that, and she basically passed with a smile on her face, so.
Yeah, and my mom had passed a few years before him, so, yeah, definitely. So yeah, I totally believe.
Yes, I do, too. Absolutely. That's wow, unusual to have somebody come to the desk like that and say
yeah,
who they
she
are.
Said it was full body. She
wow.
said it was full body, said he was there to see him. And she said, even out of her, you know, just like common sense factor, she thought, oh my God, somebody's in the building. So she searched all over, and this person was not there.
Wow. Wow.
I knew the man, knew him by name.
Uh-huh. Yes.
So.
Yeah. Wow.
Right, and then the way she said the family was freaking out, saying, yeah. "What did he look like? What was he wearing?" And she told them, and that's what the man was wearing when he died.
Oh my God, that's maybe he did that on purpose so they would believe that he was.
Yeah,
there.
That's
yeah.
true.
You know, wow, poor
so
woman.
That, yeah, but she said that's what sent her into the that she decided that was Excuse it. Me. She's retiring.
Yeah, I don't blame her. I don't believe
it.
Oh,
no way. I don't either.
Yeah,
no.
You guys do see a lot. We don't. So, wow. I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Just this past weekend, me and the other girl I work with, she works the other side. I had gone over there to help her with something. And all of a sudden, she stops. And she told me she's seen, like, this white light go across the room. And I kind of laughed her. I said, yeah, you need some sleep, you know. And
yeah.
just as I said that, I turned, and on the opposite side of the room, I seen like this black thing go.
Oh God! Oh Lord!
I was like, okay.
Yeah.
I was like, I think I need sleep too.
Yeah. Uh huh. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah. There's stuff all the time.
Yeah.
I mean, all when you work in places like that, whether it be hospitals, nursing homes, whatever
right.
hospice facilities. You're going to see that. I mean,
yeah.
you figure on it. I mean, hundreds of people
yes.
passed away in places.
Yes, yes.
Hundreds. So, yeah, you definitely, you see stuff, you hear stuff. It gets cold, you hear whispers,
mm-hmm.
you'll hear people, like things, like it sounds like people are shuffling on the floor, and you know, like when an elderly person
yeah.
walks creature, you'll hear that. And you look, there's nobody there. Or you'll be walking, and it sounds like someone's walking up behind you. You turn around, there's nobody.
Yeah, that's creepy when that happens.
Yeah. Wow. I mean, that kind of stuff happens a lot there. I think one of the weirdest things I've seen lately, though, I don't know if I told you this one or not, but we had what they call a Rosie. It's a machine that measures blood pressure, heart rate, and oxygen levels.
Okay.
On patients, you know, you go put the equipment on them, put it on their finger or whatever. Well, me and that same girl, we were hearing like this beeping noise one night. And we're like, what in the heck is this? You know, so where we go find it, and the Rosie's sitting in the nursing office, and we're looking at this thing, and it said like a 236 heart rate, and it said an O2 level of 82, but it wasn't on anybody. It was just sitting there. So it wasn't on anybody's finger.
Okay.
So that you know of. This machine was measuring an oxygen level and a heart rate of a person that wasn't there.
Uh-huh. Oh, boy. Somebody was interested in that machine, apparently.
We both just kind of looked at each other and walked away.
Yep. Okay. We'll just go away.
You get to that point, you just like, you're done. You're like, okay. Yeah, not even.
Nope, I can believe
see
that.
It. Don't care.
Yep. Didn't see a thing. Nope, didn't happen. Okay. Wow.
And lately, our doors have been opening by themselves.
Oh,
we have those sliding glass doors.
Yeah.
Yep, the ones inside keep opening and closing by themselves.
Oh, boy.
And
busy
that's,
place.
That's a weight thing. It has to, you have to step on that thing for it to work.
Yeah. You got a busy place there.
Oh, yeah.
Do you kind of get used to it, though, after a while?
You do. And age has a lot to do with it, too. Like, when I first started in this business, it was 20 years ago, everything freaked me out.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Okay, what was that? It was okay.
Now it's like, okay.
Now it's like, you know, I'll be sitting there, and like when all my work's done and in between the beeps or something, I'll be sitting there and it's like, I'll hear something. I'll hear like, a psh, you know, it's from behind me.
Yeah.
And I'll kind of look over, keep drinking my Mountain Dew, whatever.
Yeah. Keep it down. Keep it down, will you?
Yeah. The last thing that really like freaked me out and made me like, and this made me leave my unit. I was sitting there and everybody was asleep. I just got done with my rounds and all my side work was done. So I sat down for a second and there's like a dining room thing there and there was a table behind me and I was sitting there. All of a sudden I heard a chair behind me just go forward and slam into the table.
Oh.
And I didn't look back.
Nope.
But I knew there was no way there because I just sat down, you know, so. I stood up and I just ran over to the other side. And what was weird is as I ran over there, she was running back towards me. And she said she was at her linen closet. And from behind her, she heard, hi.
Oh.
And there was nobody there. So she was coming to my side because she got freaked out. And I was going to her.
And you got chairs slamming against tables. Great.
Yeah.
Like I said, busy place. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
That's great.
And like you said, I think it's a sensitivity thing, too.
Yeah.
And so there's some people that work overnight there, they never see anything. Nothing.
Yeah.
You know, shadows, nothing. Then there's other people, like her and I, we're both sensitive. We see things. And there's other people that actually see full body apparitions.
Yeah. I think it depends on the person. I really do. Certain people just, even if they saw it, they wouldn't believe it anyway. So it's almost like, why bother with them? I guess.
That's very true.
You know what I mean?
I think partly that people don't hear or see anything that works. Because it's too often.
Yeah. I they just choose not to. And that's the end of it.
Yeah. It's definitely... Like I said, we see and hear a lot.
Yeah. So, yes, absolutely.
I used to work in a facility that was run by nuns that had been there since like the 1930s.
Oh, my Lord.
Now, that building, let me tell you something.
I wouldn't want to be there. No.
No, there was a lot of stuff there. Like, I mean, just crazy stuff. I'm talking like... literally curtains would open right before your eyes.
Okay.
And and things like that just crit. I worked there for almost 10 years.
Wow.
I'll tell you what, it got to the point where even the nuns were sending down the priest to do the sacrament of the lost soul because they were seeing stuff.
Yeah. Wow. Wow.
It was.
When nuns do that, you know something's up for sure. Wow.
Yeah. Well, they didn't believe us.
Of course not.
They told them, like, all this stuff, and then there was one night just chaos broke out. I mean, just crazy stuff was happening. And nobody, it was so bad, our charge nurse took the charts over to another unit because she was responsible for two units. And she took the charts over to another unit and said, don't call me unless somebody's bleeding or dead.
Okay, wow.
And she left us there, yeah. So it was that bad. It was that bad, seriously.
Holy cow.
And it was just nuts. And then that morning, one of the nuns had come on the unit. She walked in, took three steps, looked, and just kind of backed out and closed the door gently. We're like, what on earth?
Yeah.
So our nurse had finally asked, you know, what did you see when you came? And she said that she had seen a patient that had been dead for over 3 months.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
So then wow. That's when they priest down did sacrifice, and we didn't have any activity for almost 4 months.
Whoa.
And then it started up again.
Yep. Wore off, apparently.
Something. I don't know what it is. Maybe they got scared away and then came back.
Yeah, could be.
Yeah. In this business, I've worked at several places, and even a hospital. There was my first night at the hospital, I'll never forget this. There, the med-surg had like a whole hallway that was just for kids.
Uh-huh.
And I had walked by this room, and I seen this little boy sitting on the bed, and he was crying.
Oh.
And I said, honey, are you okay? And he didn't turn around. And he said, yeah, I'm okay. I'm just looking for my mom. I said, I'll go see if I can find her. So I went down to the desk, and I said, hey, over there in room 5, there's a little boy there crying. His mom's not around. He said, look, they're like, room 5? There's nobody in room 5.
Okay.
And then one of the other nurses got this, like, almost satisfied look on her face, and I'm like, what?
Yeah.
She's like, oh, okay. She said, you seen the little boy? I said, what?
Oh.
Apparently, a lot of people have seen him and heard him.
Aww.
Yeah, they don't know. Then nobody knows. It was just a kid that died there. They don't know.
Wow.
But yeah, you could see him plain as day.
Wow.
And you could hear him, but he didn't turn around.
Wow.
Around. And I was, you know, you don't just go in and, you know.
Yeah.
Especially if the kid's crying, you don't know what they're going to do. And then over in the ICU, a lot of people took their breaks back there, and
uh-huh.
I had my break back there, and I had seen somebody out of the corner of my eye walking. They went around the corner, and I said, can I help you? And I went around the corner, and they weren't there.
Hmm. Those are the uneasy ones, because you know
yeah.
darn well you saw them, you know, full body, you know, you see them.
Well, what's even weirder, this is when I worked in the OB, you know, where
uh-huh.
the babies were born. And we used to, there used to be a big nursery there, but, you know, they stopped using the
yeah.
big nurseries
yeah.
now because of, you know, other reasons. But it was mostly used for, like, storage now. But in a nursery, sometimes you would swear you'd seen a woman walking around in there.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, I would tell them, I think there's someone. They were like, no, it's not. It's a ghost. And then they'd fly out and tell you it's a ghost.
Okay.
Okay. I mean, this is nurses, CNAs, era. It's a ghost. It's like, don't even worry about it.
Okay.
So,
don't even worry about it. Okay, no problem.
They had taken this picture for the newspaper. It was like, you know, come to the, you know how they try to tell, come to the OB, blah, blah, blah. So it's like, we're looking, and all of a sudden, one of the girls, like, got all weird-faced, and it's like, she took a picture of the picture, and she blew it up. Now, of course, back then, it wasn't a cell phone. You
right.
had to do it by computer,
yeah.
but put up and you could actually see a face in the window.
Oh.
On the other side, inside the nursery looking out.
Wow. It might have been
yeah.
a mom who lost her baby and was looking for it.
Or died during childbirth.
Yeah.
We don't know.
Yeah. Wow.
But yeah, you could literally see the face looking in the window. Like, it was actually right behind my shoulder, of course.
Oh, of course. Of course.
Of course. But yeah, that was kind of weird. But there's all kinds of things. If you ever talk to a nurse or a CNA
yeah.
or anybody that works in a hospital or nursing home, trust me, you're going to hear stories.
Oh, I'm sure.
I'm sure. Because it happens all the time. Well, like you said, there's hundreds of people that die in those places.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if it's just residual energy, there's something there that's going to, you know, mark the walls and, you know, and it's going to stay there.
Right. Right. Or if they've been there for, you know, an amount of time, that's home to them.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah, because some of those people are there for like 20, 30 years.
Yeah. So that's home to them. So they're going to come back to where they're comfortable, where they're familiar.
Or just stay there. Yeah. Exactly. I mean, I've been, you know, working and I hear water running. You go in somebody's room, they're sound asleep.
Yeah.
I've seen lights go on and off. I've heard people. You know, like I said, the little boy and then that old man, that was the weirdest thing.
Yeah.
That place, I was telling you, I was going down the hall. And I seen this old man going across the hall, and he looked right at me and smiled. And he gets to the other side, and I'm like, sir, that unit's closed. Sir, you can't go in. But I didn't hear the door.
Yeah.
And I go running down there, and he's gone.
Came to see somebody, so there you go. Wow. Yeah, I guess you would kind of get used to it. I guess the first times would be, I'd be freaking out for sure. But I guess it's just like anything else, it's just part of it. You know?
Well, that story that she sent me, though, freaks me out because it's like this man died somewhere else.
Yeah. Oh.
So
yeah,
you think
that's
about
true.
That. He died somewhere else.
Yeah.
He came to that facility, full body apparition, talking.
Yep. Wow.
To go see his father. And then he wasn't there.
Yeah. He probably helped him pass on. It was okay. He wanted to let him know it was okay.
And the CNA that was in the room didn't see him.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Or did she? We don't know.
Yeah, maybe she didn't. She just likened that.
Didn't see a thing. Yeah. I have no idea. Okay, while we're on these spooky stories, maybe I'll tell mine. What do you think?
Oh, about your dream?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, you guys, we've been trying to do this for weeks now. You've got to hear this freak. When she told me this, I was like, don't go outside. Don't open your windows. Lock your doors.
And believe me, I do. I don't go out at night. I used to, but I'm scared to death to.
Definitely tell this story. This is crazy.
Okay, there was this dream, and I take Ambien, guys, so that really prohibits you from dreaming. So I don't know why this happened. Or why it was so real. It was a little over a year ago, and I had went to bed and everything, and I was outside, sitting at the table there, outside table, and it was a warm summer evening. It was about 12, 1 o'clock in the morning, and I'm sitting outside, you could feel that little breeze and smell the cut grass and the flowers. And I'm just sitting there, and all of a sudden I hear this crazy, like, giggling. And I have a 24-foot round above-ground pool. And I saw this person dark behind the pool. Okay, he just ran real fast behind the pool with this crazy giggling. Just insane giggling. Comes around the other side, and my back was turned. So I got up, and I looked. And I didn't see anything. And I turned around, and I have another car in the driveway. Then there was a trailer piled full of crap, of course. And one, I didn't see their faces. They were dressed in black, but they had I would have taken them for older teenagers or, you know, 20, 21 at the most. And one is standing on the ground. The other is on top of this crap, this pile of wooden stuff. And he's got like a pipe in his hand. And he's just smacking it in his hand. And this other crazy person was next to him. He was on the ground, though. And he just kept that crazy giggling. It was creepy. And I just slowly walked over. I think I picked up a shovel is what it was. And I was ready. I was good. Okay, let's do this. Okay, I'm going to fight for my life.
You're already bringing it.
Okay, yeah. So I remember I hit the one that was on top of the pile. I hit him and knocked him down. I knocked the breath out of the other one, and I dropped the shovel, turned to run. Okay? And I was reaching, I'm screaming, and I reached for the door handle, and it turned black. I woke up, my mouth was open, screaming. My hand was out, reaching for the door. I was never so terrified in my life. I remember it so vividly, and it was.
What if that, like, remember how we were talking about how they reverse time? What if that actually happened?
Oh my God! That's creepy. I mean, it took me forever to go back to sleep. I was scared to death. My heart was racing.
Oh, I bet. I bet you were like looking all around
your
house.
Yes, I was. I didn't go downstairs. I was like, I ain't doing that. So from that day on, I have not been able to sit outside in the evening at night at all. I can't do
it. Oh, I wouldn't either.
I put lights on the railing on the pool and stuff to light it up some because it was pitch black. And I did that, and I think I took the dog out once about 10:30, and that's been the extent of it, of me going out there. That door is locked. Unfortunately, I have a kitchen window, which I don't look at night because I don't want to see anything looking back at me or anybody. But it, to this day, I cannot sit outside. It
that is
so
weird, especially because you said you don't dream.
I don't dream. It's very rare. And that was so vivid. It was, you could feel the breeze on your skin. You could smell everything. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, what if like that Mandela effect stuff is real and that actually did happen, and you know what I'm saying? Like you're just, it's actually an actual memory.
It could be. I don't know where it came from. Don't know why it happened. I mean,
it's weird as hell.
But I still to this day cannot sit outside.
Yeah, that creeps me out. When she first told the story, I was like, you better not go outside. You locked that door.
Damn straight I did, too,
like
boy.
I tell people I am way more scared of the living than I am the dead.
Yeah, isn't that the truth? But that crazy giggling was, more creepy than anything. Is this person giggling like a maniac. I mean, crazy giggling.
Oh, my God.
And I can't describe it. If I could think
did
of
did you,
something.
Like, watch any horror movies, like, before that happened?
No, it was like, no, because I came home after work and I sat outside. So that was how it went, because that's what I would do. I'd come home from work, change, go sit outside with a cup of coffee. So that's what I would do. And to this day, I will not go out there past.
I don't blame you.
At all. It gets dark, I ain't going out. Sorry. Not happening.
Yeah, that is a horrible thing.
I don't know. Like you said, was it a premonition? Was it a Mandela effect? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know if I want to know.
Yeah, you never know. It very well could have been a premonition, or maybe it was something like somebody actually went through that night or something. I mean, who knows?
Yeah, it's hard telling, but it was that vivid and that real. It was crazy. Like I said, I woke up and I was screaming, and my hand was, you know, reaching out for the door. So I don't know why. I haven't had anything like that since, anything like that. But that was a doozy, let me tell you. And
oh my God.
It scared the living crap out of me, totally. So, I don't know. Anybody else have dreams? Or
were you sick at that time?
No,
anything?
Nope.
Because I know, like, when I have a fever, my fever gets too high.
Oh, yeah.
Weird.
I know, one time it got so high, I wanted to go play out in the snow. It was wintertime. Yeah, I was running a high fever. Mine always tends to run high. But nope, wasn't sick or anything. Mm-mm.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it was totally terrifying, to say the least. I didn't want to go back to sleep. I was scared to. I don't know if I was scared to see the ending or what. I don't know. But nothing, you know, I went to sleep, didn't dream anymore, nothing.
That's insane. Yeah, the reason I asked about the fever is because years ago, This was quite a few years ago, I had a really high fever, and my ex-husband said he heard me from the living room going, "Let her go, you piece of, you know."
Yeah.
You know. And I was screaming, "You son of a bitch." And he said when he came in the room, I was sitting up on the bed, and I was, like, reaching for something.
Oh.
And after I came to, I remembered my room was pretty dark at the time, and I was sick. You know, I was real, you know, one of them flus where you're just like, "This is it. I'm gone."
Yeah, please, or please let me die now.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I'm there with covers on me, freezing, and I can remember. I woke up and there was like these people in robes around my bed.
Ooh.
They were these robes, and I kept saying, "What are you doing here? What are you doing here?" And one of them reached out a robe, and he was holding a baby by its leg, and it was a baby girl. And it's a naked baby, holding it by its leg, and sitting there swinging back and forth. The same thing, like you said, just kind of laughing.
Yeah, that.
And I started screaming, "What the hell are you doing? Yeah. Let her go, you piece of," you know. And my ex came in and turned on the light. And he said, when he did, I was up. I was like reaching, trying to hit something. I was screaming.
Yeah, no, I wasn't sick or anything.
I remember it.
Yeah.
But I
Yeah, but was it really the fever?
I don't know.
Another, yeah, here we go. Yeah, that's creepy.
That was creepy.
But you come to, like, I woke up, you're screaming. Like, it was crazy. But that
yours is freaky because, like, mine, I'm pretty sure, was just a hallucinating dream. But, like, yours, I mean, that's, like, it was in your house, your things, you could actually feel and see it. And the thing that weirded me out about your dream is you could smell.
Yes, it was.
You can't smell in dreams.
I didn't think so. I haven't dreamt a lot in so long because of the Ambien, you know, because that represses the dreams. You really don't dream on that stuff, on any sleep medicine like that, like Lunesta or anything.
Think about the man. I mean, no, it's weird, the Mandela thing, you know.
Yeah, I don't know. That just creeps me out even more thinking about that.
Yeah, it does creep me out because of the fact that you said you were outside, you could actually smell
and feel the breeze. It was so nice.
Yeah.
And it was maybe about 73 out at that time of the, you know, night. It was just a great summer night, and it turned into a nightmare. It was freaking nuts.
Has anybody out there ever had, like, a nightmare so real like that where you wake up and you're just, you know, definitely tell us about it because I want to hear them.
Because,
like I said, I've had this happen with a fever.
Mm-hmm.
But what Denise went through to me is worse because it's real. It's like your home. You can feel, you can see, you felt the terror, you know?
Oh. It was the most terrifying nightmare I've ever had. I want to call it a nightmare. Whether it was or not, I don't know. I don't know. Like you said.
And like I said, I totally believe that you know me, I totally believe that we're kind of going in and out of kind of a dimensional thing because of the fact, you know, like I said, like the time we moved to Northern California when I was 15 years old, we stopped off at a park and my sister says she needed to go to the bathroom, and I mean, just even thinking, I'm like, "Oh, it's back there behind that building, around that tree, blah 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 blah." And after I said it, I'm like,
"How the hell did I know that?"
And we did exactly what I said, and that's exactly where the bathrooms were. And this place I had never been to in my entire life.
Has anybody ever done that? You go to a place, but it's so familiar like that.
So that's why I believe that they do. So I don't know, you know, almost like a Matrix type thing. I don't know how it works. I don't think it works like the movie. I don't think it's that romantic. But I do believe, like, there's portals and things that. Or a past life. Who knows? Maybe a past life of mine was there. I don't know.
That'd be interesting to find out.
I always felt comfortable there. When everybody else in my family hated that place, I felt comfortable there.
Wow. Yep.
Yeah.
Could have been another life. Do you guys believe in past lives?
Oh, yeah, that's...
That's a whole nother ballgame.
I think I do.
Yeah, I don't know, but that, I mean, it was, that nightmare was in,
the
like,
story of that Audrey Rose, I think, is what really made me think of past lives. And then those kids that are like 6 years old, they can tell you about World War II airplanes and... You know, stuff like that. So I do believe in past lives. I think that it's almost like a recycling thing.
It could well be. They say sometimes that you have past lives because you haven't accomplished what you need to. So you keep coming back until you get it, I guess.
Yeah, there's some people that believe that you have to keep coming back and coming back and coming back till you basically reach perfection.
I guess.
Well, then you get to move on.
Oh, well, perfection is not going to happen here.
So. Well, you know what I mean. Like, yeah, you know, where you're a good person, you're not evil, you're...
I don't know, but yeah. I had a lady, and this was when I was like 18. I was working in a restaurant, waitressing, and this lady jumped up from a table. She looked at me. She goes, you were a princess in Egypt. I'm like, excuse me? I thought this lady was nuts. And she went on babbling on of what I was doing and everything else. And I'm like, okay. And just kind of went back in the kitchen until they got her out of there. But now you think back and you wonder, you know. I had this irrational, I hate snakes. I am terrified. Well, back in Egypt, where did they die? The asps, you know.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
that's weird. Like my granddaughter, she's terrified of being in a closed room. She cannot stand doors being closed.
Wow.
She'll even leave the bathroom door cracked when she's going to the bathroom because she is just terrified.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, the other day, the baby had closed the door to the room, and my bedroom door, the knob kind of sticks a little bit where it almost feels like it's locked.
Yeah.
You have to pull it a little, you know. Well, the baby had closed the door, and she went to go open it, and it did that, and she's screaming.
Oh, my God.
I'm trapped! I'm trapped! Somebody help me! I'm trapped! Let me out!
Yeah, oh, my goodness.
She's in a bedroom. She's not, like, in a box or something.
Yeah, oh, my gosh. Wow.
Yeah, so I opened the door, and she's just, I mean, big alligator tears coming out of her mouth. I mean, out of her eyes, just freaking out.
Aww.
It's not coming out of her nose because she felt like she was trapped. So it makes me wonder, like, if something happened in a past life where she, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, I agree because, well, Dakota.
She has no reason to be like
no,
that.
No, no. Yeah, that's kind of, you wonder where they get that. Act very well could be. Now, Dakota, I think she's a sensitive. She talks to my mom, who is passed. Like we said, she's passed.
I remember
passed.
You telling me, yeah.
And my dad will come over, and, you know, he misses her, of course, and everything. And one day she was playing at home. Now, she's 7. And she came in and told her mom, great grandpa thinks he's alone, but he's not. Great grandma's there with him. Great grandma's there with him. He's not alone. And I think Jessica asked her something, and she goes, well, she comes down from heaven through the portals of heaven. Through the portals of heaven. Now, where she got that, I have no idea.
Yeah, how would she ever know about anything?
And then she said, you know, grandma said that she's with him. And that was the end of it. She went back to playing. I don't know. She just does this. This isn't the first time. And what is strange, and I think there's a correlation here somewhere. Dakota was born 3 days after my mom passed.
Oh, it's very possible, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? She's never met her, but she knows who she is.
Yeah.
So, was there a soul?
Oh, yeah. That's absolutely, see, I think my grandson has, I told you about my daughter when she was little, she used to talk to spirits and things like that, and my grandson, I think that he has it too, because he likes headphones on, like even when he's watching TV, he would rather it be one of those remote headphones.
Yeah.
He likes to have headphones on, because when he's watching TV or anything where he doesn't have headphones on, he'll be watching TV, and all of a sudden he'll, like, look to the side like something just said something to him, and he'll keep watching TV, yeah.
Oh.
So I think that he has it too, but he's like grandmother who chooses to ignore it.
Yeah. Gotcha. I gotcha there. But she's just out with it, just matter of fact. And it's like, okay.
That's how my daughter was.
Yeah.
Just be like, oh, mom, this cable. It's like,
But it could be maybe their souls passed at one time, you know, after my mom passed. And she was born 3 days later. So,
yeah.
You know.
Never know.
I don't know.
Your mom could be visiting her. I mean, it's like I said, I believe in all kinds of things. Yeah. Like, you know, how do I put it? I don't believe, like, anything's possible, but I do believe a lot of things are possible.
Yeah.
I totally do, and I don't have a closed mind to things like that, because I don't believe in a, well, this is how it is, and that's it. No,
yeah,
I believe
there are
different levels of so many things.
Oh, yeah, I agree. I almost think that they kind of passed each other or something. When she was born and Mom passed, that somehow, I don't know.
It's very possible, or she might just be coming back to...
Well, it was weird. When she was about 3, Jessica heard her babbling on in her bedroom. She woke up and started talking. And Jessica went in there and she said, "Who are you talking to?" "Grandma." And she said, "No, Grandma's home in bed." "No, you're Grandma." Now, how the hell did she know the difference?
Yeah.
You know? And it's just, that's just how she is. And maybe ask her a question. I talk to him sometimes. Like, you don't, you know? She's looking at you like, what, you don't talk to him? You know, that kind of look. And it's something that she does. I don't know. But I think somehow, maybe when she was born, Mom visited her before she crossed. I don't know. But
maybe,
it was really strange.
It's like she said, coming from the portals of heaven to visit.
Yes. That is how she said it, the portals of heaven.
You know, or portals of whatever. You know, it's like I said, I believe that. I believe that there's just not a definitive answer on after death. I don't necessarily believe you just die, you go up to heaven, that's it.
No.
You're done. I don't believe necessarily people stay on earth to become ghosts. I don't, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
I think it's like almost like an individual type thing.
Yeah, yeah. Depends on the person. Yeah, I agree.
Depends on the person. I think it also depends on how they died. I think it's, you know, on if they want to leave. I mean, you just...
Yeah, yeah. There's a lot involved. There's a lot more to it than just, you know, this is it. I agree with you 100%. But, yeah, just...
So, like, I've also experienced in, like, the nursing homes, where even after people have died and, like, their stuff's gone, their family then got their stuff, the janitors, whatever, cleaned out the rooms, and they're ready for the next person to come in, I can still feel that person there.
Yeah. Yeah. I can,
like, get the same vibe when you walk in that room. So, I don't know if it's just strange.
So, oh, excuse me. Goodness.
Your mother very well could be visiting her.
Oh, I believe it. I do, because... there's no question about it. She knows.
Yeah, at 3 years old, you're not going to know the difference between a grandma and your grandma.
Yeah, she goes, "No, Mom, you're a grandma." It's like, okay. She was like, okay. And then she just kind of, she didn't push her or anything, which we don't. We just listen to her and, you know, maybe ask a question or two. And she goes.
3 is about the time when all that stuff starts coming out, because my daughter
they
was the talk. Same way. I told you about the boy in the closet.
Yeah,
you know?
Ooh, yeah.
She knew that I asked him to leave. She knew it. And she was gone at the time.
Yeah. Wow.
She was out having ice cream. When she came back, she was mad. She said, "Thanks a lot, Mom." Like that. I mean, just like that. 3 years old.
Yeah.
My friend told me that you told me you had to go. Well, now I'm not going to have a friend anymore. Yeah. So she knew that I told him to leave.
Yep. And the only way she could have known that is if he told her.
Because she came home all in a happy mood, and she goes in her room, and she's in there for maybe 4 or 5 minutes, and comes out, and she's just glaring at me, and she's got her fist to her side. "Thanks a lot, Mom." At 3.
I hear you. Yes. 3 going on 15. I know what you mean. It's crazy. They're crazy.
Exactly.
But
that's true with sensitive kids, too. Like Christy, she had the friends that she did have as a child, you know, I'm talking like pre-15, people were freaked out by her.
Yeah.
I mean, they were. Parents really didn't want their kids around her because she was very, she talked like a 40-year-old.
Yeah.
You know, she talked like she knew everything about the world. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like, she was very mature for her age. And she always was. So, and a lot of parents have freaked them out. That freaked them out like you would not believe.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's mean.
So, Yeah. Where their kids are like, you know, still trying to figure out how to blow bubbles with their bubble gum. Yeah. She's like,
yep.
Gum's bad for your teeth. You're going to get cavities.
Yep. Yeah. There you go.
And they just kind of, you know, and she would, like, go through their houses and they tell them what the dangers are in their house. You know, parents don't like that kind of stuff.
Good for her.
Yeah, Tim, you think plugged into that outlet, if you don't fix that, you're probably going to have a house fire.
Love it. Get out, child, now. Yeah.
And that's just how she always was. And then when she got to be a teenager, she found out being weird kind of got you the aisle of misfit toys of friends, like I was, you know. So it's like then she kind of fit in with people because nobody fit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Whereas a child, you know, you kind of have your friends chosen for you. And a lot of the parents did not want her in their house.
Oh, that had to make her feel bad. That's terrible.
Well, no, it didn't make me feel bad because, I mean, she kind of creeped me out.
But I mean, she probably felt bad. Couldn't figure out why.
Well, she always found herself beyond. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
She always saw herself as beyond her peers.
Oh, good for her.
Like, but you know what I mean? Like, she always did. She was always the type of kid. The only kid that she ever fit with when she was young was this little girl, Sabrina. And she was exactly like her.
Ah.
They would go out and they would talk to the trees and name the trees.
Okay.
And tell me what the trees were upset about.
Oh, okay.
Because they swear the trees talk to them.
Okay. Hey, who knows?
You know, so I'm just, you know, so that was the only little girl that she really fit with when she was younger. But the other, it was like just, she wanted nothing to do with them, really.
Oh, well.
She was perfectly happy reading a book at home versus, and she's still like that as an adult. She doesn't like to go out. She doesn't like to go places.
Huh.
She doesn't like to be around other people. She's just a strange person.
Maybe she just picks up something from people, you know? And in general, they're jerks.
Yeah, like I said, I'm kind of like that, too.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I don't like being in restaurants. I don't like being in movie theaters. I don't like being in stores. I just, it's one of those things. And it's not because I hate people. I get very vibey from people. And I guess I just don't
that one time in Walmart. You said you just left your cart and out you went.
I did.
Yeah.
I said, F this.
Yep. Now, I don't go do that very often. It's like once in a blue moon, but I will go shopping or whatever just to get out besides working. So, I mean, other than that, I'm pretty much a little homebody.
The only time I like to go to Walmart is in the middle of the night when there's nobody there.
Nobody's there, yeah.
I like to go in where I can look around. You know, I can go aisle to aisle, like at the clearance stuff, and look at things without having 10 million people trying to push their way through.
Oh, I agree. I agree. It's like in the summer here, I don't go anywhere near anything on a weekend because it's going to be like that, and I hate it. I hate it.
Yep, I hate restaurants. I loathe restaurants. I hate being in restaurants. I can't stand people.
I hear you. I do. I can relate totally.
So I can kind of understand her to a certain extent, but she's still a lot more inward than I am. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
She's just one of those people. She just likes her walls, and that's it.
That's okay. That's okay too.
That's exactly it.
Yep.
Like I said, there's still a few people she'll visit with and talk to. You know. And that's her friends, like I said, from the Isle of Misfit Toys. That's what I do.
That's okay.
You know?
Yeah.
We all kind of fit because we didn't fit anywhere else. You
that's
know?
Right. Exactly. Exactly. I know what you mean. Exactly.
So it's very possible that your granddaughter is going to grow up to be that kind of person. Because, like you said, she already talks like she's an adult.
Yeah. Exactly.
And trust me when I tell you, other people's parents don't like that. The other kids' parents don't like that.
Yeah, that's okay, too.
Yeah.
Get over it. Yeah, that's okay, too. I mean, she's going to be who she is. And that's that. So they can get over it.
Exactly.
She's not going to, we're not going to make her change to fit in. No, that's not going to happen. Nope.
Exactly. But sensitives, you know, I've read up on this. Sensitives are like that.
Yeah.
They're just very reclusive people because of the fact that they don't like the vibes and the things that, you know.
Yeah, I can understand that. I can understand it because it could be very overwhelming, I would think.
Oh, yeah. Well, you're supposed to do, like, certain types of yoga and things like that when you're sensitive, but it's like, I've never done that. Maybe I should. Maybe I wouldn't be such a witch all the time.
Okay. You're on that
side. I'd be a little happier in life. You know?
No. I don't think you're a witch. Stop it.
Well, you know what I mean.
Yeah,
like,
I do.
I have, like, no tolerance, you know?
Yeah, I don't either.
I don't.
At work, it's like zero tolerance. It's like, really, are you kidding me? And what the bleep every 20 minutes.
Well, like our last plan at BOB when we got cut off,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
We got cut off and we had called out the CEO of Walmart
and
the CEO of Kroger. You know, it could have just been a technical difficulty, you know? But of course, you know, I'm like, I'll just keep coming at them.
I never know.
You're like, damn straight, we're going to
sleep. Yep, damn straight. I'm with you on that.
We're like instantly going to the, it cut us off because we called out the corporate bastards.
Yep, and boom, it cut out.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of cutting out, did you see, have you noticed something that isn't being posted anymore?
And isn't being posted?
Is not being posted anymore.
Oh, about that Area 51 thing?
Yeah, they removed it.
They removed it?
Yes, they did. They removed it.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
Well, from what I understand, too, the guy who started that thing, it was supposed to be a joke. And he never expected it to get like that.
He
may have removed it.
No, they said Facebook removed it.
Really?
Which means that came from higher up and told them to remove it.
Oh, wow.
Yes. Yes.
But it's still... Oh, yeah.
Yes.
It's still supposed to be on September 20th. Yep. Though someone else started up a new one, they're not going to keep it a secret.
No, that'll be... No. But it'll probably be removed next week or so, I'll bet you. That'll be gone too. But yes, Facebook removed it, which tells me they were told to remove it.
Yeah, see, they have another one now. It says Storm Area 51, they can't stop all of us. There's 296 people right now.
Uh-huh.
So they're still, they started it again.
Yep. Well, I think all them people that signed up, you're going to see a lot of them there. But again, a lot of people think that the military will use force. I don't know if they would or not. They are it's posted.
I'm kind of on the fence on that one. Because if that happens on September 20th, if there's actually people that are going to be dumb enough to do this, trudge across the desert to go in there, I don't think that the government would do that because there's going to be media there.
Oh,
I just can't imagine them shooting people on live TV.
Although, true.
I think they're going to arrest them.
Yeah, that's what I think. But these other people are saying, because they have a right to, it's posted. They will use whatever force necessary. And if you're that dumb to go across there, then...
Yeah, but if they're just going to use their two little guys in their white Jeep, you know, they're not going to stop 100,000 people.
There's more than one.
I know there is, but I'm talking about in general at first.
Yeah.
You just see the two guys in the white Jeep or white SUV. Yeah.
But, I think they'll arrest them.
Personally, I think people are stupid because we all know that, the UFO, you can call it experts or whatever, they removed a lot of the stuff from Area 51 and they put it in that new base.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yes, in Utah.
And there's nothing there.
Nope, not anymore.
There's nothing there.
No. So, I don't know what's going to happen. I guess we'll have to wait and see.
I mean, people have to remember, this is a military base.
Yes.
Like, storming Area 51 is no different than, like, freaking storming Edwards Air Force Base.
There you go.
You are trying to storm a military, a United States military base.
Yeah.
So think about this one for a second. This isn't just on UFO playland. This is classified stuff that's right there. And this is a military base. So this is no different than storming any other base. So if that's what you're planning to do, you are all kinds of stupid. That's
I agree. Yeah, all kinds. Yeah, absolutely. I mean,
all kinds of stupid.
I mean, yeah, they can't stop all of us. But those... You get arrested. That's a felony because you're trespassing on government.
They can't stop all of you, but they sure as hell can arrest a lot of you.
Hell yeah.
Federal prison is not going to be kind to people like you.
No, absolutely
not. You're not rich.
No, absolutely not. So really think about this. You're trespassing on government property, period. That simple.
Exactly.
So I think I'd like to go. If a lot of people are, I just want to go way back and just watch it unfold. You know, just see how stupid people are.
Oh, there was people that were, like, forming military, like, assault plans and stuff.
Oh, not
cool.
Did
you see this online? They were literally, like forming in groups and planning on, like, okay, you're going to storm here. People are talking about bringing weapons.
Not a good idea, guys. You'll get shot for sure. I mean, at that point.
They probably have stuff in the ground that'll electrocute you.
Yeah, just
bring up these little wires and bzz, you're gone. You know what I'm saying?
This is like... open season for all these militias.
Yeah.
No.
So, no.
Not a good idea. You have a weapon, you're gonna get shot. There is no doubt in my mind.
Yeah, they were people like, okay, we're going to go to this gate and that gate, and you're going to go here. We're all going to rush, and, you know, if they bring out their weapons, we'll shoot this guard and that. I mean,
oh, you're going to shoot the guards. No wonder you got removed. Jeez.
Yeah, but they weren't talking about it on that page. They had, like, side pages where they were literally talking online, talking about their assault.
And so not a good thing to do, because I'll bet you those are down, too. Check it out.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Let me see.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was one. It was called Area 51 Militia or something.
Oh, dear God.
That was ridiculous.
Nothing like drawing attention to yourself.
And it was public. That's what really...
Yeah. That was dumb. Just curious to see if they're still up.
Let's see. Let's see.
Just curious.
Yeah, oh yeah, they're gone.
Yeah, I figured they would be. You start doing that shit.
They would be gone a while ago.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been some time. So that brings us to alien abduction insurance. Which is, I laugh, but it is the truth. And lots of people, thousands of people, have taken out alien abduction insurance.
What?
Yeah. And remember when that was up, they can't storm Area 51, they can't stop all of us. It seems as though people in the U.S. have actually been preparing for something like this for a lot longer. Since 1987, people have been taking out insurance packages to protect against alien abduction. 6,000 people have this. The policies are worth $10 million. And it will pay out if folks are lucky or unlucky enough to be abducted by aliens.
And then, how do you prove that you've been abducted by aliens?
I don't know. Probably a process. And then placed back down on Earth. But you will need to have a signature from a legit alien. There you go.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I was wondering. I was like, okay, now how on Earth? Okay, so it's just, it's another thing like Area 51. It's probably a joke.
Nope.
No, really? Yeah. It's actual insurance?
Altamont Springs in Florida. They also offer asteroid and reincarnation insurance. You think I'm kidding? No. The insurance packages cost $24.95 and include a paper copy of a certificate in a frame, or you can save the planet and a bit of cash and get a digital one.
That's like right up there with buying land on the moon.
There you go.
You know?
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
Have you seen that thing where you can buy land on the moon?
Yeah. Yeah.
Because they're claiming that they can sell land because nobody really owns the moon.
Yeah. Here we go.
Like, Yeah, so they're claiming that you can actually own a piece of the moon.
Yeah, I've seen that. Yeah, I don't think so.
I mean, it'd be cute as a gag gift. I mean, but everything's going, like, towards aliens now.
Yeah.
Like, even, Bernie Sanders, that's who we're talking about. Yeah. Bernie Sanders claims that if he gets elected, he's going to release all information on aliens.
Now, there's a running platform for you. Okay, Bernie.
Yeah, let's start a riot.
Yeah. But this guy jumped on the chance for more business that the coverage now includes Area 51. If it is stormed and the aliens are definitely living there, are released. You can get insurance policy on that if they're actually there. The policy includes outpatient psychiatric care, sarcasm coverage, and double identity coverage, according to the site. And he, this St. Lawrence guy, talked to Fox 35 News that at the beginning, these insurance packages were meant to be as a joke, like you said. But people are buying it. People come to him.
So, okay, so let me get this straight. You pay for insurance for a $10 million policy that you can only get if you can get an actual alien to sign that they abducted you.
Yep.
Now, how do you prove that this was an alien, though?
I don't know. Listen to this. And in case you're wondering, one guy has actually managed to make a successful claim. One policyholder enlisted the help of an MIT professor who was able to state that an implant found in the man's body was not made of an earthly substance.
That's happened to a few people,
yes,
though.
And they took this as proof.
And they paid him $10 million.
Yep.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so there you go. But it started as a joke, but people have taken it seriously. They come to him and they get this abduction insurance and now the Area 51 insurance. So it's in Florida. Mike St. Lawrence is his name. Altamont Springs in Florida.
So what's the area? There's a difference between the alien abduction and the Area 51. Now, what's the Area 51 insurance?
Yeah, if it is stormed and the aliens that are definitely living there are released, if they free the aliens, then they'll pay out for the Area 51 insurance.
So if they storm Area 51 and they release the aliens, they get money.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Couldn't our government take that as like a hired hitman or something?
I don't know.
I was just sort of thinking about that. Like that's almost like hiring a hitman.
Yeah.
To go take over the base.
Yeah. I guess. I don't know.
I don't know either. That's just, I don't know. I just think all this stuff, I mean, it's like you said, it started out silly and it was funny, but then it got to the point of, like I said, when those people were talking publicly about how they're planning an assault.
Yes.
Like, I'm not just talking, they're not, you know, this isn't like Patriot Game where they're like, oh, I'm running for
their flag. Yeah, I mean, exactly.
This is like, people are planning like actual invasion assaults on a U.S. military base, and it's like, I don't think they're thinking clearly.
Yeah, no, you think? I think this, they're taking this as, okay, we've been planning for this all our life. No, not a good idea. You know what I'm saying? They think this is a way, I don't know. I don't know what they're thinking, to be honest with you. I no, that's not cool. You go in there with a weapon, you're going to get shot. Sorry.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, not even the ones that aren't going to get shot. You're going to get arrested. They're going to have extra people there.
Oh,
They're going to bring in backup.
You let them know. How stupid was that?
And it's like, you have to ask yourself, is this justified, though? Like, okay, like, technically our tax money pays for the military and the military bases.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, do we have access to it or should we have access to it? I don't know.
I don't either.
I'm kind of broke on that one.
I'm the same way, because if you do, and then you're letting everybody else in the world know what you have. Okay, some things just need to be left alone, I think. You know, of course, that doesn't cover everything. Some things. But you know damn well they've anything alien related is gone. They're not going to have it there now. I mean,
oh, of course not. You know, that would be like you saying like you've got, you know, you had an alien in your house or something.
Yeah, here they come.
Then people are saying, hey, we're going to invade your house on this date. Would you still have that alien in your house? No, of course not.
There you go. So, yeah. Crazy stuff out there now. Crazy stuff. And like I said, all that's
insurance.
Yeah. I thought that was hilarious myself, but people have actually gotten it.
That is wild. Yeah. And then like, politician claiming that he's going to release everything if he gets it's like, you know, way to use the aliens or pal.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Whoa. Like they're going to tell you now anyway. They may not even tell you about anything. So I don't know. That's crazy. That's a running platform for you. I don't know.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Can you even promise something like that? I mean, isn't that like national security? Isn't that kind of like the jock who plans to have every Fridays off in school if he gets elected school president?
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, that's
you
it.
We'll have every Friday off, yeah. You know.
Yay! You're elected. Then we don't get it. So, yeah, that's exactly. Good analogy there. I like that. Yep, exactly. But I don't know. Crazy stuff out there. Crazy. It's really, I don't know. Would you go? I would go just to see what happens. Way back.
Go to Area 51?
Not to Area 51, just on the outskirts, just to see what happens. Because I'd laugh my ass off.
Oh, yeah. Like, if you're talking, like, watch it from far away, sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would never actually. Part of that, because that's just dumb.
Mm-hmm.
That's like a federal offense. That's like a terrorist act.
Apparently.
An American military base. That's just not
smart. Well, apparently, somebody agrees because they took them all down. They took them all off. All those. Now, somebody started a new one. They may last a week. We'll see. Could be because of all the new
FBI. See on September 20th if they all show up.
Yeah, I like to know how many people are going to show up. That's going to be interesting. Interesting. Wow. Crazy stuff. Be amazing if, you know, 1,000 people showed up. But I have a feeling they're going to have quite a few people there.
I think so, too.
I think it's going to be
more. I don't think just because Facebook took it down, I don't think that it's done.
That probably made them even more determined, if nothing else.
Well, yeah, they started up another one.
Yep. So that's not deterring them at this point. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. They may make an announcement before that date. If you come, this is what's going to happen. So who knows?
Yeah, I honestly don't think they're even going to be able to get
past the gates. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're going to set up barriers and they're going
to. Yep.
You know, because I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're in a big crowd of people or not. If some military guy standing there with a freaking gun pointing at you and says, okay, if you step forward, you're getting shot.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. And they're not going to be able to shoot everybody, but some of them. To die, and are you willing to die to really find out if there's aliens in Area 51?
Right, exactly. Yeah, I don't think that's worth it. No, absolutely not. So, how about maybe it's because of all these UFO sightings. What do you think?
Oh my God, what's this deal with Pennsylvania?
I don't know.
There's been over like 6,000 in California, they said, since 2010, but for some reason lately, Pennsylvania's been on the hot radar.
And even they're getting serious attention from Congress and the U.S. military.
Yeah.
So,
Is it Virginia or is it Pennsylvania where that underground fire is? That it's fired
Silent Hill, PA.
Yeah.
Oh, so, I don't know. Let me check it out. It could be West Virginia.
I can't remember if Virginia or Pennsylvania.
Yeah. Silent Hill, PA.
Okay, so I'm wondering, maybe like they're attracted to, you know, heat. And I don't know. Maybe I don't know.
I don't either.
But Pennsylvania is such a. I mean, no offense to anybody who lives in Pennsylvania, but it's just a weird state to see.
Probably because. Yeah, probably. I don't know.
Because, I mean, other than the big cities, there's really not much to Pennsylvania.
No, and that's probably could be why. I don't know.
It is. I'll tell you what. I traveled through Pennsylvania once at night, and it is the creepiest state.
Yeah, I remember going through Beaver Falls.
You feel like you are being watched.
Yeah, it is not a good state to travel through.
I have traveled almost every state in the United States, day and night, and I can tell you, Pennsylvania at night is one of the creepiest states to travel through.
I have to agree with you. It is.
You are being watched every second.
I have to agree with you there. I remember passing through Beaver Falls, PA. No man's land. Let me tell you what. Wow. I have to agree with you there. I did not like it one bit. I couldn't wait to get out of that state. Could not wait.
I had to drive from that state from one end to the other. Yeah.
Oh.
I mean, the long way. And it was like the longest drive ever. And like I said, I just felt like the entire time, like something was just going to jump on my car or something.
It's creepy through there. There is no doubt. It is creepy.
It really is.
And actually, Congress is apparently taking it seriously. The Navy reports of this. So.
Are you talking about the ones that were following the Navy ships?
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, they're taking them seriously, and the military is actually taking notice in Pennsylvania.
Yes, they are.
That UFO sighting in that Springs.
Yep.
They're taking it very seriously. Very seriously,
Yep, they said they've had a surge of UFO and Bigfoot activity. Now, we have I wonder if it's a, like we talked about, a dimensional portal type thing.
Very well could be, like dimensional portal open up and then they come through. I've always said that because there's just been too, I mean, for me, there's been too many Bigfoot sightings to say that this thing does not exist.
But
this thing cannot possibly live that long if it's just one or two. Right. So there's going to be a colony somewhere, and I don't believe it's, I know people are out there going,
I agree with you.
No, I do. I totally believe it's like on another dimension or another, you know, parallel universe or something. They're able to cross over. Yeah.
They've never been caught.
No.
And you'd think by now somebody would have caught something. But they very elusive, and that really, you know, explains how they're, you know, all of a sudden nothing for a while, then they pop back up. Then you can't find them. Then they're back. And I agree with you. There's got to be a portal somewhere. Yep. It's crazy in PA. I don't know. If you live in PA, tell us. Let us know what's going on over there.
Yeah. Has anybody witnessed anything? Have you?
Yeah.
Have you seen, like, you know, any weird creatures?
Yeah. I'm anything. Serious. Yes.
I really want to know. Have you ever seen anything weird, like creatures?
Yes, and it was in Big Creek Parkway. We have a Big Creek Parkway in Cleveland, and it goes through miles. And a lot of it is, you know, wilderness. And you drive through there. And with some friends one night, we pulled in to where Bigfoot fighting had been seen. This is honest God's truth. And we were looking up on the ridge because it's a real big, like, cliff type thing, and then up top, so it's like a ridge up there, and between two trees, five of us swore to God we saw something there.
Something. Oh wow!
Yeah, it couldn't have been more than maybe a quarter of a mile away, not even from where we were sitting looking up. I would have to say less than a quarter mile. We could actually see something in between the two trees, like kind of watching us. It was kind of creepy.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, yeah, we've seen something.
Years ago, I had seen something, there's two things I seen in Connecticut that really was disturbing to me. One was crypto, the other one was just disturbing. One crypto thing I seen, I took this different way home from work one day. And I seen this thing on the side of the road. It couldn't have been more than 4 feet tall, but it almost looked like Cousin It. It was standing upright on 2 feet, and it had, like, long hair. And it bothered me so bad that I even went and got, was my husband at the time, went and got him. I was like, yeah, look at this. And he said, you probably just saw a beaver. I'm like, no, I know what a beaver looks like. It was not.
He's really big.
It was not some otter. It was not some freaking squirrel. I don't know what the hell that thing was.
A baby Bigfoot. I don't know.
That was bad. The other thing that I seen, that this one scared, it still gives me chills to this day. My husband at the time, we used to take drives at night because his mom would watch the kids. We would just go out on drives, you know, it's just fun. And it had rained that day, and whenever it rained there, it's like it would get like this ground fog. And he asked me if we had, if I had ever driven around. I forgot which lake it was, but there was like this lake. I said, no. I said, I don't think I've ever been over in that area. So we're driving, and we get around this corner, and he was telling me about this old graveyard that's there, like really old. And I said, oh, wow. So we get around the corner, and right at the gates, there's this guy standing there. And he's not even 2 feet from my window because these are really curvy roads. And this dude is covered in dirt. Dirt and mud. And his eyes were, like, huge. And he's just, like, watching. Oh, my God. I thought he was going to reach out and open my door.
Oh, God. That is disturbing, to say the least.
Yeah. And then he wanted to go back. I was like, no, I'm screaming. Don't you dare go back.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he was standing right at the gates of the graveyard.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, and he was just covered in dirt.
Oh. Yeah, I wouldn't go back there either.
That freaked me out so bad.
One of the more recent sightings in PA was near Youngstown side of Chestnut Ridge. It's Youngstown, Ohio, so it's just on the other side, because I know where this is. And that was one of the sightings in June. But July 4th, an orange-red sphere spotted around 10 p.m. in both Erie, Cecil, and Washington counties. A shiny silver disc or saucer overhead at Mount Lebanon. Took about 15 minutes before it disappeared. That was June 28th. Yeah, there's tons of stuff that people have seen this year. And this is just recently, so it's not like it's, you know, 10 years ago. This is this year, this past June and July especially. So,
yeah.
Crazy.
Oh, wow.
Crazy stuff in PA. I don't know what's going on there, but if you're seeing an increase in UFO sightings there and Bigfoot, correlation, maybe. So.
It's possible. Yeah. I mean, it still freaks me the hell out. I don't know about anybody else.
Yeah, it does me too. Yeah, yeah.
They seem to be attracted to water, heat,
nuclear
stuff. Especially the Ring of Fire.
Yep.
Out west.
Yep. Yep. 63 UFO sightings reported in PA this year so far. That's so far. And Navy pilots were reporting this, not just, you know, regular people.
Yeah.
Navy pilots were encountering UFOs at hypersonic speeds. So, if they get involved, you know it's serious. So, what is going on?
I don't know. There's some freaky stuff going on. That's all I know.
Including one in York County, PA, in the past 2 weeks. So, there you go. And one resident saw four stationary lights in a diamond formation. The lights were located between Jupiter and Saturn. A very detailed sighting occurred on May 29th on the Pennsylvania Turnpike between mile markers 318 and 317. Triangle-shaped objects with blinking red lights on the edges, white lights in the center. There was no structure below it. They thought it was a communication tower, but nope, there was no structure there. It was about 300 feet over the ground, hovering over the turnpike. May 23rd, over Elkins Park, PA, a UFO appeared to pursue motorists.
Pursue the motorists?
Yeah. Two orbs hovered on either side of the car and followed them all the way to Wawa, PA. The orb stopped and waited while they went into Wawa, then continued following them part of the way home. Oh, my God. Yeah, nothing new. Yeah, I don't
know. I'm wondering, what do they call those things? The drones, can they travel that fast?
No, that's why the Navy pilots have reported it. So apparently not. And that is why
now I know they have these drones that you don't need propellers for.
Yeah, no.
So I'm wondering how fast they can move.
Apparently not. That's what it is, because the Navy pilots are reporting this and they're taking it seriously. Recently, President Trump was briefed. Senate lawmakers received a classified briefing this week about such objects. And there's a strange Facebook video that seems to show a creepy-looking alien doing a dance down someone's driveway.
What?
Yeah. So they are serious about this. They have had meetings recently.
An alien dancing down somebody's driveway?
Yeah, doing a jig. So... Elkin, look, where was that? It doesn't say. Facebook video, creepy looking alien. Oh, just, I'm looking, I just went to it. Let's see what it is. That's why I wish we had visual aids here.
Right.
You know?
Creepy looking video of alien.
Yeah. I don't know.
Let me see.
Yeah. Crazy stuff. So there's a lot going on behind the scenes we don't know about with the...
Oh, yeah.
Apparently Congress and them, they've all... some of the Senate lawmakers have had a classified briefing on this. The Navy's involved. So if it was a drone, I think they would have said so by now.
Oh, yeah.
So, crazy stuff.
Yeah, I'm not seeing that video anywhere.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know where it's at. I'll have to look for it. But, yeah, a creepy-looking alien doing a jig down somebody, some sort of jig down someone's driveway. So, I don't know. I'll have to research that a little more.
Oh, yeah. That's weird.
Mm-hmm. So, lots of stuff going on. And this is just recent stuff, guys. It's not just, you know, this is 10 months ago. No, this is this year. So, past couple months.
Yeah, I know. Remember when we were kids, it was always like the videos they would show you of aliens UFOs were like from like the 50s or, you know.
Oh, yeah.
It was like
these
20 to 30 years prior. So, like, you never really thought about it. But now it's like we're seeing videos of UFOs and things like that from, you know, from like 2 months ago.
Yeah. And, let's see. The Navy uses the term UAP, unidentified aerial phenomenon.
Yeah.
So.
UAPs?
Yep. UAPs.
Well, because if you think about it, these little orbs, it could be anything.
Yeah.
It could be paranormal. It could be alien. It could be some kind of spy thing from another country
that
they sent here to spy on us.
That could well be, but an F-18 Super Hornet pilot reported his sightings to the Pentagon and Congress. He was one of the multiple pilots who saw UFOs. They began seeing the objects in 2014 and 2015.
Have you watched that show yet?
No, I haven't.
It
and
covers
I have
all
to.
Of this.
That's
it
what I want to see,
this.
Yes. Initially, yeah, the sightings kept happening, showing up at 30,000 feet, 20,000 feet, and sea level. They could speed up, slow down, and reach hypersonic speeds. And these things would be out there all day, they're reporting, the pilots. So, I don't know. So, for these Navy pilots, and they're taking it seriously, apparently. So, don't know. I don't know. Are they getting braver? Are they going to
eventually... I don't know. See, and I'm not fully convinced that it's alien.
I don't know.
And the reason I say this is Adolf Hitler...
Oh,
back
yeah.
before World War
yeah.
II was building like what you would consider mm-hmm. a standard UFO.
Right.
It had like the round dish shape yeah. and it had reverse propulsion and it literally looked like something out of a Jetsons movie.
Right.
You know, and we basically, like we've discussed this before, we basically kidnapped their scientists.
Right, right.
After World War II.
Yeah.
And we put them to work for us.
Yeah, that's so the Russians wouldn't get them. Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm really not fully convinced that any of this is alien. I'm wondering if it's not stuff like, you know, because you think about it, we have drones.
Yeah. They admitted that.
To the American public.
Right.
Without propellers that can go a certain, you know, they can go way up high and go this way, that way, upside
yeah.
down, whatever. So how could we not have something that looks like a ball that could just fly
I would agree with you, except for the fact that they're having briefings on this. The Navy pilots are telling their stories.
But they don't necessarily have to know about it.
They admitted that we have unmanned aerial drones. They did in the article.
Okay.
But that is...
But you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, these Navy pilots and these Navy people may not have even known that they were being experimented on by our own government.
It's possible.
It could be, you know... Mm-hmm. This could be surveillance.
Could well be. Could
this
well
could
be
a new kind of surveillance. This could be something for Trump's Space Force.
That's a possibility. Absolutely.
So this is why I'm not fully convinced yet, just because of that fact.
Yep. Yeah, it's real possible. Not out of the question.
Because I don't think that every alien sighting is, or every UFO sighting is alien.
No. I don't think so either.
I think it's
but supposedly a majority of those are. I don't know. I honestly don't know. So, I don't know. That's a real good possibility, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I totally believe that people get abducted by aliens, too. So
oh, yeah.
So it's like I'm kind of on both sides of the fence here because it's like I totally believe that our government has stuff like way beyond shit that we don't even
dream of. Yeah, yeah, I agree.
But I also believe that there are aliens that are here.
Yeah.
Dimensional aliens.
Yes, yes.
I don't believe ones that are coming from outer space and light years away.
Right.
I believe in dimensional ones.
Yes, yes. That is the key there. You know, they're not from way outer space, another galaxy. There's portals. Yes, I agree. I agree. What do you guys think out there?
There's so many people that believe all kinds of stuff. Like even Steven, one of the owners of our station here, he believes in aliens. Like,
oh, yeah.
Outer space, like... They're coming from other planets, aliens.
Yeah.
Then you have ideas who don't believe in aliens at all.
He thinks believes
they're
in demons.
Demons.
Yeah. Yeah. One end to the other.
Yeah. And you have us. We believe that it's dimensional, like a dimensional portal is opening up.
It explains so much as to why.
Yeah, to me it does, too. It makes a lot more sense.
Yes, absolutely.
I mean, if you have to have aliens, that to me it makes more sense to have dimensional aliens.
Well, you know, where did they go then?
I believe they don't exist, that they're a conspiracy by our government.
Yeah, that's true.
To get people off the trail, they're... What the heck was that?
My spooky door. Sorry.
Oh,
I was closing.
God.
Yeah, spooky, ain't it?
Maybe a heart attack.
My spooky door.
Jeez. Oh,
crazy.
My God.
Nobody's sneaking up on me.
They're discussing aliens. I'm like, holy crap, she's got one in her house right
yeah.
now.
Yeah. Spooks. Nobody can sneak up on me, and that's for damn sure. All right. Here's doors. So, yeah. Yeah. Crazy.
But, you know, there's people that believe that it's a cover-up. That yep. there is aliens. That think that it's a story created by our government to throw us off the trail of their brand new planes and their brand new spacey stuff.
Do you think?
That they're building. Yeah, I mean, that's what, there's people that believe that.
Yeah,
that's true. And there was never aliens, that this has all been manufactured as a story by our government.
Huh. I don't know. I'm kind of on the fence with that one.
Yeah. Like I said, it's hard to know what to believe. Me personally, if there is aliens, I think they're coming through a dimensional portal.
Yeah, I agree. Bigfoot too,
only
as far as that goes.
This is something that's ancient. Ancient Indians.
Oh, yes.
Native Americans, I mean, you know, Incas, things like yes. that. They talk about these things.
Yes.
You know, yes. So it's not just something that we just stuck up in the, you know, just this last century. This is something that has been going on
yes.
for thousands of years
yes.
that they wrote about. So
yep, this isn't anything new. So, you know, yeah, many cultures have, the Native Americans even.
Yeah.
Yeah. They firmly believe in the skinwalkers. So there you go.
That's creepy.
Yeah, that is creepy. Shapeshifters, skinwalkers. Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, they really believe in that. And they believe, you know, there are other things going on in the, you know, that we are not aware of, so to speak, as they are.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. There's so, there's too many accounts, too many stories to really rule it out totally. Too much out there. So I can't honestly, you know.
There's just too many. And like I said, it's kind of like with the whole thing we were talking about with Planet BOB the other night. I believe just the same with like this whole, you know, UFO alien situation. I don't think there's one answer for everything.
No, exactly.
I think there's multi-tiers involved here.
Yes.
I think it's everything like people imagine. I think it's our government trying to cover up the fact that they have new surveillance system. I also believe that, you know, that we've been opening, you know, the portals have been opening
yes.
for years, and we figured out how to manage them.
Right.
I, you know,
yes,
I totally
CERN. Yeah.
Stuff, you know, so.
Yeah, we kind of touched on that last week with that.
Yeah, the CERN, yeah.
Yeah. Yep. And the Mandela effect, for sure. Yes, absolutely.
So there's so many things.
Yes, absolutely. Like you said, multi-tiered again. Here we go.
That's what I forgot to look for today, was to see if there was any new Mandela effect.
Oh! Take a look, real quick.
Yeah, I want to before we get out of this, because I definitely want to see. Let's see if that's back on. Oh, let's see. I had to turn that down there. Oh, of course, some guy talking.
Oh, of course.
I'll have to look at this later and
yeah.
get better.
We'll update it next couple weeks and see if we get any more info on it. If we do, we'll definitely, you know,
I'll
let you know.
I'll send you the link to your messenger, so. So you can have it for later too. So
yeah,
we'll definitely discuss this in a few weeks, because this is something to me that is just wow.
It is mind blowing, to say the least.
Because I literally and I believe it, because I get headaches when we
yeah.
discuss
it. Yes, it's like,
it's not because it's like so like, oh god, this one. No, it's just because there's just some crazy.
Yeah, yeah, it's
there's just stuff. So there's just some crazy stuff with timeline shifts, so.
Yes. And like we, you know, I said last week, you know, people sometimes say, boy, this year went fast. Did it? Or didn't it?
Well, yeah, and that happens all the time. You have some days and you're not doing anything different
yeah.
than the day before.
Right.
like, that day goes by so fast, like, gone, and then the other one's, like, drags on forever. It's like, is somebody just resetting it so it just drags?
Seems that way, don't it?
It really does.
Okay, I gotta let my cat in. Hang on, I gotta open the door again.
That door?
I know. Like I said, nobody's sneaking up on me.
We need some WD-40.
I know, I have it, but like I said, nobody can sneak up on me because I'll hear the damn thing.
That's true. That's true.
So I'm not sure if I want to use it. So.
Yeah, that's a good idea. It's a good defense.
Yeah. I'm alerted. So, anyway, that Mandela effect is just mind-blowing. It just hurts my brain.
Yeah, there's some stuff, like I said, there's some stuff that's like, well, maybe it could have. But then there's other stuff. You're like, there is no way in hell it like that.
Absolutely.
We know better, you know.
Yep.
There's just some stuff that, like, there is no possible freaking way that hundreds of thousands of people could have heard and saw the same thing.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden they're like, No, that's not what it is.
Yeah, it is. You guys screwed
like
with
Tom
it.
Tom Cruise wearing a pink freaking shirt.
Yeah, no way. No freaking way.
That was like, no.
Yep. It was the shades and the white shirt and the socks, because he slid across the room.
Yeah, but now they're saying it's a pink and white striped shirt.
Yeah.
With no glasses.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, because he turned around and was singing. He took off the glasses as he was dancing.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So, yeah. Too much.
Yeah, like I said, there's some stuff like you were just like, well, you know, maybe we just spelled it wrong all those years, or maybe, you know, maybe it was this. But then there, like I said, there's stuff. It's like you got to think when we were younger, especially.
Uh huh.
We remembered stuff pretty accurately only because these were like our favorite things.
Yeah, absolutely. They were simpler back then.
Yeah.
You know.
Songs, lyrics. I can remember lyrics and songs from like 1982.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the second it comes on, I sing along with it. And then, like, for them to say that the Queen song.
Yeah.
You know,
oh, yeah. No freaking way.
We are the champions doesn't end with of the world. That they're suddenly saying, no, that's not how that ends.
And we know
it's
better.
Like, oh.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there's just, like I said, you cannot tell hundreds of thousands of people that remember it the exact same way.
Exactly.
That, no, that's not how it's been. You're wrong.
Yep. Well, you have that one proof that it is that way, that live footage.
Yeah,
the
exactly.
only one that wasn't changed.
Exactly. But this is what they're claiming. They're claiming that he did it live, and that live version hit the radios.
Uh-huh.
And that's why we remember it that way.
Yeah, I know.
And I'm like, bull. Because it was on the album. I had the album.
Dang straight. Yeah, you and me both. Who didn't have it?
Exactly. Or I had the cassette, I should say. But still, I had it.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. So, yeah, we're not all wrong. Got news for you. Absolutely not. But yeah, just certain things. And the Flintstones. Come on.
Yeah.
That was our Saturday morning cartoon thing. Come on.
Yeah, and there's just so many things. It's like, it's just crazy. And it makes you wonder what they've changed so far.
Yeah.
I can't wait to watch that video.
I know. You and me both. You and me both.
Yeah, we're definitely going to update everybody in a few weeks. I think. Yeah. We'll delve in a little more, too, of the Mandela effect. Like, what it is.
Yeah.
Why people are claiming this, what exactly is a time shift?
Yeah, good idea.
It's not what you think. It's not like, you know, some magical thing. This is like science involved in this.
Yes.
This involves like the whole God particle thing, the whole business.
So
there's a lot more to this than what you think it is. So.
Don't miss that one for sure.
Yeah, so in a couple weeks people love to seem to hear about this, and we'll go over some of the old Mandela effects and some of the new ones.
The new ones.
The lists, and, you know, and I want people to tell us what you think.
Yes.
It's too much? Do you think we're just looking for stuff, and, you know, or do you think that we're, you know, just imagining things? I mean, I would love to know.
Yeah, let us know, please. so we can read them on the air. Or join us in the chat.
Or is there something that you've noticed?
Yeah.
Have you noticed a Mandela effect? Have you noticed something that you knew for a fact was a certain way and now it isn't? So.
Yep.
Even personal ones, even if it's not like famous ones, something personal in your life that you thought was a certain way and all of a sudden now it's not.
Yep. Yeah, I think one of the big ones is the Tinkerbell one with Disney. That's a big one. Yeah,
that is for me too.
That's a big one. So, yeah, we'll delve more into that and hopefully we can explain it in simple terms.
It reminds me of an old episode of Roseanne.
Oh.
when they replaced Becky and at the end it showed like an older DJ, which is actually John Goodman was playing the older DJ. They say she's the same, but she's not the same. They say she's the same, but she's not the same. That's what this Mandela effect seems like to me.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah.
So yeah, that's what that reminds me. I was like, that's what I feel like doing. They say it's the same, but it's not the same.
Yeah. There it is. Yeah, that's perfect. Actually, that kind of pinpoints it. It's the same, but it's not the same.
Yep. Yeah, exactly.
Yep. So join us for that for sure. So, anything else to add?
Not that I could think of. Just everybody just watch up in the skies.
Yeah, watch the skies.
A chance, just like even in your bedroom, just open up your blinds and just look out the window while, you know, just turn off the lights, look out the window and watch stars from your bed. You never know what you're going to see.
Very true. Very true.
Never know.
That's right. Just take a drive. You never know.
take a drive. Yeah. Look up. You know, just be aware of your surroundings. You just never know what the hell is going to happen
anymore.
Got that
right. That's got that right. That's for sure. You just never know. So.
Like I said, if you can think of like any kind of Mandela effect or anything like that, that even it's happened to you personally, like something that you, like let's say like a family member, you know that they you know, they used to look a certain way and now they're saying, no, that's not the way it happened.
Yeah.
Is it a Mandela effect or is it something that you just misinterpreted?
Yeah.
I want to hear about it.
Yeah, we do. Absolutely. Absolutely. We want to hear from you out there. So keep an eye to the sky.
An eye to the sky.
An eye to the sky. Yeah. Reminds me of a Alan Parsons Project song. Eye in the sky. So, yeah. Never know. But keep an eye out, and we want to know. So, absolutely. So, what do we got going on? God, we got preseason football already going on.
I know you're doing that.
Yeah, sports will be coming back. We have AHS this fall. We have TWD. We have sports. God, we got so much going on.
Actually, let's rephrase that. You have so much. Yeah.
This is true. I'll be doing sports. I'll be doing AHS, TWD, DWD, Hollywood Review, and of course our Ecto and Encounter show here. So yeah,
and Planet BOB.
Yeah, Planet BOB too. So busy, busy, busy. It's going to be a busy season. We got Halloween coming up. I want to secure the interviews for the haunted houses. I got to go out and do that towards the end of the month. So it's going to be a fun season this year. Fun season. So, yeah, we got a lot going on. A lot of shows. So, tune in.
Busy.
Yeah. Yep. I hope I have the time to do it. I'll fit it in somewhere. So, but AHS, I'm so looking forward to that.
They're going back to the 80s. And it's going to be like almost like a horror theme.
Yeah, that slasher theme. Yeah, it's going to be cool.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, TWD, that's looking awful good.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. And we're down to the Atlanta 2, which is so sad. I'm just like, oh.
I know, just Daryl and Carol.
I know, Daryl and Carol. Daryl, my other brother, Daryl. But yeah, Daryl and Carol.
They're both like psychotic in their own way, so that's what's cool about that.
Yeah, they are. She's going into beast mode.
They're both like the picture of the reckless and abandoned, and they're the only ones left.
Yeah, isn't that the truth? But we'll see what we see with that. And, of course, sports. We've got football coming up. Oh, it's totally awesome. So don't miss any of these. Let's see who we got on. Oh, isn't Ike coming on? Is Ike coming on tonight? The Jam, Ike Dog?
It should be Ike. Ike Diaz.
Ike Diaz. Ike Dog and the Jam.
He should be here.
Yeah.
He should.
So, he should be here tonight. Tomorrow I'm doing DWD because I was like out in the boonies Thursday. Wasn't a good signal. So, hope you caught Freaks in the Basement last night. Good music last night.
I did. I caught a lot of it. I was listening.
Good music last night.
Yes.
Yeah. Good. Glad you were tuning in just to listen at least.
I always do. I try to at least have it where I'll have like an earbud in. That I can't.
There you go. I know that one night. The troll's coming. I got to go. So I just busted out laughing.
Oh, yeah, that troll, she comes around a lot, man. When you see her, you better not be doing nothing because she'll be taking notes. So.
Just tell her it's Mandela Effect. You just thought you saw that. It's okay.
Right.
Yeah,
exactly.
It's a memory thing. It's okay. So, yeah, don't check out Freaks in the Basement and The Jam, DWD. So I'm going to do two shows this week, DWD tomorrow and Thursday. So. Since
there you
I'm
go.
Back in civilization. I apologize for kind of giving up on fear because it really, I was done.
Yeah.
I was just done with it. I just couldn't.
It's coming back.
Yeah, I know. Maybe we'll do a recap and do it. I'm really not happy with it.
It kind of got out there a little bit.
Out there, yeah, and that thing with the kids.
It's starting to remind me of Z Nation.
Yeah, that's it. Yes, definitely.
It kind of went from what Walking Dead was to almost like a Z Nation type vibe.
Yeah.
Which I love Z Nation, but Z Nation was...
Is Z Nation. You got Murphy. Yeah. You got DJ Quarles there in the hut.
Yeah.
You know, I just...
I love DJ Quarles. My favorite.
Yep. And Doc. He was hilarious. Love Murphy, though. Good show. But yeah, I have to agree with you. I couldn't think of what was reminding me of, and that's it, actually. I just got so fed up with the storyline. It's like, God, you could have done this in two episodes. The kids, it's like, they don't want you. Don't you get it? Go away. They survived this long. So just leave them alone. Don't force yourself. Like, no, we're going to help you. They don't want your help, okay? That was really driving me up the wall. So, yeah, I kind of just gave up on it. I didn't even watch the last two, to tell you the truth. I just couldn't do it. I recorded it, but... I was done. So we'll see. But yeah, I don't know what they're thinking, but we'll see.
I don't know either.
Yeah. We'll see what happens. But definitely TWD, you know, we'll be on with that. Hopefully Woo-hoo! Michelle can join me once in a while for that. That would be great.
I would love it. That would be so much fun.
I know. We did a couple of them last year you did with me, and those were fun. Enjoyed them. So hopefully, you know, we can get you on again. So lots of stuff coming up. So be sure to tune in.
And if you want to listen to any of the shows, you can go to KBLP LLC on Facebook. And you can go to KBLP LLC4 on YouTube. And you can get to any of our shows. Listen to them anytime. Scroll down. There's a shows button and an episodes button. So
there you go.
Check them out anytime you want.
And you can go to our Ecto and Encounters page also.
Exactly. Get links to our shows.
Yep.
We've been trying to post more there for Ecto and Encounters. So, yeah, definitely go check it out.
Yeah. Any more shout-outs you got?
Let's see. Just the Walking Dead Freak Show.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And we have True Horror Junkies.
Yeah.
And we have Horror Three Ring Circus and Ghoulies.
And Gremlins.
Gremlins.
Yes.
I'll get it one of these days.
Yep.
And it sounds weird to have three different, but they're all three actually three totally different
They are.
Types of groups.
Yeah. Yeah. Just check them out.
True Horror Junkies is kind of like the anything and the everything of Horror Three Circus. That group mostly runs on like the older stuff and the kind of humor side of horror, and Ghoulies and Gremlins also is kind of like anything and everything. So
yeah, a lot of Adriana posts a lot of info on there about movies and what's going on. Yeah. So be sure to check it out. A lot of movies we post there too. So there you go. Kind of that in a nutshell. So that's it for me. I got nothing.
Not anymore. I think we're all done with tonight. But okay. Yeah, definitely tune in a few weeks. We're going to be discussing more into the Mandela effect, CERN, also the connection with other countries, because this isn't something that people think it's a U.S. thing. This is not a U.S. thing.
No, it is not, believe it or not. So, yeah. And we'll discuss it then. But yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I got that right. That's about it. So thanks for listening. Have a great rest of your weekend. And peace out, y'all.
Peace out. Good night.
destination unknown. Double-cross messenger, all alone. Can't get no connection.